Hello, my love bugs. Thank you so much for joining me here at Kara's Love Techniques. And today we are talking about how to date someone with emotional baggage. Okay. So welcome to my channel. Be sure to like and share and follow me on Instagram. So let's just get right into it. We are all at some point going to date someone with, you know, little emotional baggage or heavy emotional baggage. Either way, I'm just going to sort of break it down to you of what it's like to date someone with emotional baggage, all right? And I mean, we all carry a little. Some of us come out of relationships with scars, and then others come out with deep wounds, you know. But I just want to share some of the cons and pros of what it is, what it's like to date someone who is carrying a great deal of baggage with them. So the cons would be, you know, initially they may come off as a bit overbearing. They may seem like they're just too much to handle all at once. And that could be because they are going through, you know, different bouts of emotions, anxiety, excitement. So it could weigh heavy on them to just simply take another chance at dating, and that's where the overbearing nature comes in. And also, they may rely on you for their happiness, so you may find them, you know, reaching out to you a lot or periodically throughout the day at times where, you know, it's really your time and they're reaching out to you because they need to hear your voice or whatever the case may be, whatever it is that keeps them going. So you may find that this person is simply relying on you to keep them happy. Yeah. And throughout the whole dating process, when you begin to understand them more and what they're going through and what they've gone through, you may even begin to realize that he or she has wavering emotions. And see, what that is they have periods to where they are, you know, just for the dating, they're really interested in you, and then there could be moments to where they just completely pull back or maybe moody, may not understand what's going on, or just come off as aloof. And it's confusing, you know, especially as the dating progresses and it becomes more serious and feelings are beginning to get involved. So they may seem as though they're not interested when they really are. It's just they have these wavering emotions that take them through channels and they take you along with them. Quite confusing, right? Constantly needing reassurance. They may need you to do certain things or say certain things that you may not even normally say, you know, especially in early stages of dating. They may need that from you. And almost as though it is like a demand, because they're relying on your happiness or relying on you to keep them in that stable place emotionally and mentally. So yeah, there's that. And lastly, the most important thing about dating someone with emotional baggage, especially someone who has a great deal of baggage, and not just from one relationship, from several. The thing that you may not know or that the person you're dating may not know is the depth of their wound. You know, how scarred are you? Some of us, we come out, like I stated in the beginning, with just scratches. Then there are others that come out severely wounded. So that could be another con to dating someone who is emotionally damaged. Yeah. But some of the pros to that is these people are usually strong believers. And I say that because you have to think of it in a way that if you are the person that came out of not maybe just one relationship, a marriage, or several, well then more so than likely is you are the one who were putting out the most emotion. You were the caregiver. You were the emotional nurturer in the relationship. You had to have been doing far more to come out so damaged. It's very rare in a relationship where both people come out emotionally damaged, because one usually moves on gracefully. You know, they're a little scarred. Like I say, they come out with scratches. They're a little wounded, but then they continue to date. And whereas it's the other person who's severely burdened by this loss. And it's very, very difficult to get over it. You know, so more so than likely, you're the one who was the most heartfelt in the relationship. You cared more. So that's actually a great quality. You just ended up being with the wrong person. Okay. And it also shows that you have emotional depth. Your heart is deep. You know, you love deeply. You wear your heart on your sleeves. You're an emotional giver. And that's a great thing, right? Yeah, we all want that. We all need that from someone. And you usually care more deeply for the person far more than you do for yourself. Now, that is a good quality in a sense. However, you have to learn, if you have not already, especially if this is like your third or fourth go around, you have to learn to love yourself more, okay? Because when you're dating someone who is emotionally damaged, when we come into these people lives, we're just like an accessory. You're a mere accessory. Without that accessory, you know, that belt or that necklace, you're still a wonderful person without. You should still be content with who you are, and vice versa. Yeah, but that's just mainly it for the pros and cons. Not a whole lot to go by, but here's the thing. When you're dating someone who is emotionally damaged or they have that baggage, the only thing that you can really do is, if you really find yourself falling from them, is just be supportive. You know, just tell them to just relax, just chill out, you know. Don't make any promises, though, because you don't know how you're going to feel in the months to come. Things change, so you can't state or make statements that say, hey, well, maybe in a year we'll go to Aruba or something. Like, make these promises. We have to stay away from these promises, okay? Because these types of people, they will hold on to that. They will cling to that for that reassurance and just kind of like use that as like a security blanket, your words, among other things. Yeah. Be patient with this person. Be patient. But here's the one thing I want to say this. With dealing with someone like this, we don't know the severity of their wound, how hurt they were. If they really healed totally, we don't know this. So my advice to you is, if you can endure this sort of relationship, by all means do so. But if you find that it's a little too overwhelming, it's a little too much, there's too much emotion involved, there's too much trying, well then take yourself out of it. Remove yourself away from the situation. It is not your job to try to fix someone. And I think this is what many people do going into these relationships with someone who's emotionally damaged. We try to fix them, and that's not really your place. You really can't fix a person unless they find within themselves a way to heal. They only know, that person knows their how severely damaged they are. Okay? So with that amount of damage, that's how much it's going to take to overcome that. And only they know that. All right? So just wanted to share that with you. Hopefully this has been somewhat insightful. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. But I thank you for joining me. Until next time.